The Enterprise lives on. I'm Brian Moore, and this is Focus NNS. We're here at the Virginia Air and Space Center in Hampton, where the Newport News shipbuilding documentary, Building Integrity, Building Ford, premiered in November as part of U.S. National Navy Aircraft Carrier Month. We'll tell you where you can see the film. Plus, the USS Enterprise lives on as steel from CVN 65 is prepared to be part of the next Enterprise, CVN 80. And 2017 comes to a close. We asked shipbuilders to choose the top stories of the year. The results are coming up. But first on deck, as we have previously told you, steel from CVN 65, the first nuclear aircraft carrier ever built, will soon be part of the next Enterprise, CVN 80. The next step of that process is underway, and Aaron Pritchett with our Communications Division joins us now with more on the story.
Like every good book, you hope you never get to the end. But for the legendary Enterprise CVN 65, the story continues as the next chapter for the Big E reveals that the first nuclear-powered aircraft carrier built at Newport News Shipbuilding is officially on to its next journey to give new life and a renewed spirit to the newest Enterprise, CVN 80.
It's a big deal. It kind of take it to heart. It's history. Basically, add a little history to a new history.
Just to finish it up like this is really a big deal to me.
In July 2016, shipbuilders were hard at work in Dry Dock 11, the very same dry dock that Enterprise CVN 65 was brought to life, defueling her and preparing her for decommissioning. But right next to this once mighty ship, a very small but extremely important process was taking place, and one that would preserve the past and help bring new life for the future.
Considering the flight deck extension itself wouldn't allow the ship to fit into Dry Dock 11 due to the crane envelope, it was a simple decision to be able to utilize that piece of material for the next CVN 80. Careful calculations were made to determine the correct amount of material that would be needed for a meltdown, and of those calculations, it was up to us to be able to cut it accurately, make sure we removed the right pieces, and made sure that we palletized it in a fashion that would be easily able to store and retrieve.
For just over a year, the numerous pallets of steel cut from the Big E have been stored away safely and securely in a Newport News shipbuilding warehouse. And in November, the time came to ship out, so the heavy lifting began.
And so this morning, we're actually removing the material from our warehouse and putting it on trucks to be shipped out to Pennsylvania, where the foundry there will melt it down and be ready to install on our new carrier. Very important. We feel very honored to be a part of this process, my team and myself. We've taken a lot of pride into making sure that when this day came, we'd have the material already and available for ship out. Just knowing that this material was on the original carrier, it means a lot. It's protected our country for many years. And now to know that part of that history is going to be added onto a new carrier, and just to be a part of that process is an awesome feeling.
We'll continue to follow the journey as the past becomes part of the present and soon-to-be future of the new Enterprise CVN 80. For Focus NNS, I'm Aaron Pritchett. Back to you, Brian.
All right, Aaron, thanks so much for that, and we will keep you posted on the progress. Now, let's take a look at some other news from around the yard. Los Angeles-class submarine USS Helena, SSN 725, is at Newport News Shipbuilding for work known as a Dry Docking Selected Restricted Availability, or DSRA. The submarine arrived in October for the upgrades and repairs. Work is already well underway, and the team expects to complete the DSRA in a 5.5 month time frame. The Helena was built by Electric Boat and was commissioned in 1987. Dozens of shipbuilders and their families attended the Integrated Digital Shipbuilding Open House in November. Shipbuilders set up displays showcasing new technology and how it will be used on the job. Attendees learned everything from augmented reality to digital work instructions, laser scanning, and additive manufacturing. The open house drives home the shipyard's focus of invest in improvement of people, technology, and facilities. Speaking of people and technology, shipbuilders are testing drone technology to bring inside the gates for the very first time. Facilities is practicing flights at the Apprentice School football field. The goal is to use cameras attached to the drones for a number of inspection jobs, which can be more efficient and a lot safer. The plan is to first test drone technology in the North Yard at the JMAP. Remember, all NNS drone purchases must go through plant engineering and security to ensure compliance required for flying on shipyard property and FAA regulations. The Virginia Air and Space Center is a great place to learn about the past, present, and future of military and space technology. So what better place to debut the premiere of the Newport News shipbuilding documentary, Building Integrity, Building Forward. The nearly hour-long retrospective takes us back to 1996, when CVN 78 was just a concept and didn't even have a name. A special one-time showing was held to culminate National U.S. Navy Aircraft Carrier Month, which is recognized every November. Another showing was held at the Huntington Ingalls Industries headquarters. Don't worry if you missed these showings. The documentary is now available on the Newport News Shipbuilding website, on our YouTube channel, and on Cox Cable Channel 1886. Shipbuilders can also check out a DVD copy for free by contacting the 029 Communications Division. And speaking of movies, 1977 was the year Star Wars came to theaters, and it was the year 359 shipbuilders began their careers at Newport News Shipbuilding. They were honored on December 6th as part of the Master Shipbuilder Ceremony. Lena Wallace with our Communications Division has the story.
It's a high honor at Newport News Shipbuilding, earning the title of Master Shipbuilder.
It's a great feeling. After 40 years, it's just a great feeling. It makes you feel like you have accomplished something in life.
I thought it was gonna be like 5 years or 10 years and then I was gonna go, but then it just kept on going and going and going.
It was a nice responsibility, you know, responsibility to build ships for the Navy and, you know, you're building their home, actually. And you want to do it right because you want them to be safe because they're protecting our country. So it gives you a sense of pride in what you're doing.
The honor goes to shipbuilders with 40 or more continuous years of service.
What is so truly remarkable to me is that even after 40 or 50 or 61 years, many of you continue to feel the call to continue working. That is dedication like no other.
This year, 359 new Master Shipbuilders join the ranks.
I would like to ask all of the Master Shipbuilders here tonight to please stand for a very well-deserved round of applause.
It's a night of recognition and fun, celebrating four decades of hard work. For Newport News Shipbuilding, I'm Lena Wallace.
All right, thanks so much, Lena. And the ceremony included a video looking back at 1977. It features some of the 359 shipbuilders who were honored and includes some of what was happening back in 1977, like the movie Star Wars. You can see the video for yourself on the Newport News Shipbuilding website, on our YouTube channel, and on Cox Cable Channel 1886. Well, another year comes to a close, and to say 2017 was a busy year might be an understatement. We polled shipbuilders to find out what they think was the biggest story of 2017, and here are the results from number 10 right on up to the biggest story of the year.
Number 10!
The work that we're doing now, in 10 years, we're gonna look back and say, how do we ever build ships without that?
Number 9! I feel honored, I'm just grateful. The shipyard has been a blessing to me and my family. And you know, I'm just honored to be here.
Number 8!
I mean, this has been an amazing place. It's the thought that you have made a decision to leave all your best friends at work.
Number
done.
Number seven.
All right, everyone count down with us. Three, two, one.
Cut that steel.
Number six. Officers and crew of the United States Gerald R. Ford, man our ship and bring her to life.
Five.
We engage the employees, we listen to their concerns, we get down on the deck plate, we go into the shops. Management has to take a proactive stance, listen to them, and help give them the resources to make a difference.
Four.
17 of my 30 years I've worked on this ship, and so it's kind of hard to say goodbye.
It's part of history. It's part of being an American. It's part of being part of the world.
Three.
The fact that we even have the capabilities to work on three ships of this size at the same time is amazing.
Two.
Congratulations to all of the men and women who helped build it. This is American craftsmanship at its biggest, at its best, at its finest.
One!
I'm extremely honored and humbled to serve as the 20th president of Newport News Shipbuilding and as the first woman to hold this position.
It's just good because I think that she's looking for out for our best interests. And she encourages us, you know, because she's come so far and she's accomplished a lot.
Well, there you have it, a big year in 2017 and even more to come for 2018. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of Focus NNS from the Virginia Air and Space Center in Hampton. And don't forget, the Virginia Air and Space Center is offering discounts to Newport News Shipbuilding employees now through early 2018. All the details are on the Virginia Air and Space Center website, on the NNS To Go app, and in the November 13th edition of Currents. And we'll be back in 2018 with more Focus NNS. Before we leave you, here's a thank you to all the people who make Focus NNS possible. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Brian Moore.